afternoon, guys. The continuing saga with Orange Spain. And I'll be honest with you, we do get bored of these videos. It's not for you. It's for all the customers for Orange in Spain and also the customers in the future to prevent them becoming customers. What I'm going to do is actually explain about the telephone call again today. All right, sorry. I'll start at the beginning because some of you guys have no idea what I'm talking about. Back in October, we were moving house, we got new internet. Orange promised they would get it installed straight away, etc. And 4 weeks later, still no installation, still no dates. They're lying as well because by this time they're saying, oh, you weren't at home, nobody was answering the phone, all this sort of stuff. In reality, it's Orange, they're lying. They have no installers because the installers are Movistar. But at the same time, Movistar are a bit awkward as well because it's on their network. And at that time, they just had a tower fire, you know, transponder fire. So their engineers were busy. But they don't say this. Orange don't go, oh, you know, Matt, it's been a delay because there's a problem or whatever. They'll go, you know what? I've just spoken to him. He's going to call you on Friday. He'll be, and I say, are you sure? He's definitely, yeah, he'll call you on Friday and uninstall on Friday. That's the sort of stuff they do. Comes Friday, you sat in all day, nothing happens. And then you're going, oh, what's going on? Oh, they try calling you. And I said, no, they haven't. They can install next Tuesday. They can install on Tuesday. We reschedule it. And then you go, following week, nothing happens. It's the same, it just goes on and on and on because they can't install. Now, that's just one problem in Spain, generally. They don't like other people on their own networks. So Orange doesn't like Movistar on theirs. Movistar doesn't like Orange on theirs. So it's like childish stuff that should actually be illegal and heavily fined. But they don't. They get away with it. So that's one problem. They sell you a package with mobile phones you don't actually need. Myself, I have a UK number. I don't need a Spanish number because I use WhatsApp. So anybody who wants me on a Spanish number can call me on WhatsApp. Anybody who wants me on a UK number can call this for the same as a UK rate. So they don't get any premium rate calls because some people get paranoid about calling me out here. Also, if they have an internal system in the UK, they can't actually call me because international dialing's locked out. So that's why I have a UK number. Don't want a Orange mobile, but it's packaged. That, oh, it's this, it's free, it's a part of this package, da da da. So you go, okay, don't really want it, but have it anyway. Then you get home and you're like, okay, they're installing in a week or whatever. And like I said, just drags out, don't install. After 4 weeks, you're supposed to have this cool off period where basically, if they haven't installed it, you can cancel the contract. What they did is they actually renewed it without my authorization. And now, bearing in mind, I'd already spoken to Movistar. I'd already spoken to their rep here as well, who actually said, well, if they're not going to install it, they're not going to install it, because it's very common to get this issue. So their Orange rep on the phone, it automatically re-queued for an installation. I hadn't asked for this. Now, bearing in mind, if you'd said, Matt, can you give us another week to install? That's fine, you know, because it's not a new contract. I'm not asking you to extend yourself another 4 weeks contract window. I'm asking you to basically get it in next week or bugger off. Simple as that. What they did, though, is start a new contract to give themselves another 4 weeks. They didn't install it in that time anyway. You know, even after that, they still hadn't managed it. But they then start trying to bill you for the phones. And they say, well, the internet's not in, but yeah, you've got to have the phones now because you've got a contract for phones. And you're like, I didn't want the bloody phones. Yeah, but if you order internet now, you can install it. What? You couldn't install it in the last 2 months. What, and suddenly you can do it? I don't think so. So basically, everything was returned. Before, in week five, I think it was, everything went back. Everything, SIMs, a lot, Orange got everything, got all the receipts for everything. Everything went back to the agents, etc. And then Orange refused to cancel the contract. They're saying, well, you've got the mobile phones. It's like, I don't even have the SIMs and I never had phones. Yeah, but you've got a contract. You've got to cancel that separately. It's like, I don't have to cancel it separately because I had a package. It was one thing. It was one contract. No. They're a separate contract. Now, talking to the Orange guy that works at the Orange shop, he's had the same issues. Because what they did to him, because I basically said, you're now in charge of getting rid of this. Here you go. And he has spent a fair bit trying to get them to just cancel the contract. So the first thing is, you haven't installed the internet. And he's got the emails showing that they haven't installed it because obviously they email backwards and forwards to him because I made it his problem to sort it out. They refused to cancel the contract with him because they were saying, well, you can't cancel the internet app because you've got to wait for the second cycle of the second contract before you can cancel the phones because otherwise there's a €200 fine. And it's like, €200 for what? Well, the phone contract. But we didn't want the phones. And this is the thing. The guys even had this. It said, we couldn't install the internet. So why would they want to pay for the phones that they don't want either? And that's basically where it's been going. So bear in mind, this finished October. They've had everything back since October. They've called them and said, look, you've had all your equipment back. You failed to deliver. You breached your contract, etc., etc. They ignore all that. They then go, you've got the bill to pay for November. And I phone him up, says, no, I don't, because I don't have any of your equipment. I can't be dialing your phone. I don't even have your SIM card. Oh, yeah, but you still have a contract. It says, contract's terminated. Yeah, but you still have the bill. You can terminate if you pay the bill. And I'm like, but if I pay this bill, are you telling me that you're not going to bill me next month because you'll terminate the contract? They didn't respond to the email and they didn't respond to the live chat with the same question because I know exactly what they'll do. They will take the money for November. Then December, they will then turn around and bill me regardless if I've cancelled the contract or not because there'll be some reason they haven't managed to cancel it. The same reason when the guy was actually trying to cancel it that worked for Orange, they said, oh, the computers are down. That was the one as well. Because the first one was, you've got to wait for the other contract to expire for installation. Then the next one was, oh, the computers are down. And it basically, the guy that even works for them cannot cancel this contract. And this goes on. And today they called again. And I said to the woman today, I don't have a contract with you. And she's like, yeah, but you have to pay it. And then send in this letter to cancel the contract. I says, I don't have a contract with you. You don't understand. There is no contract. You breached it. It's terminated. Me actually putting a letter of cancellation would then make me responsible for a 2-year contract or a 12-month contract to make all those payments with a penalty on it. But they didn't deliver the contract. See, this is the bit that people got to be careful with. Because the point being is, you have an admission of guilt by accepting the contract. The fact is, there was only one contract that was requested, which was for the internet. These mobile phones were part of that package. They're not a separate package. They want to separate it so that they can bill you for the mobile phones for the 12-month contract or fine you for that 12-month period. It ain't happening. Now, I'm going to share some websites with you. And I will admit, I'm going to keep going on about the Orange Spain because I want to damage their business where I can to stop people buying from them. What I recommend is get an Orange SIM from the UK if you just want a mobile phone. Sorry, not Orange. Oh, bad words. Use 3. I found 3 really good from the UK and I still use my 3 SIM in Spain. I've had no problems with 3. They've been wonderful. Even when my phone was stolen, they sent me a new SIM. No problems whatsoever. When I loaded up my wrong number before with 3, I put all my money on the wrong phone number. They actually put it on this one. Really good company. Orange, I think they would fit in with an old spaghetti Western as being a bunch of bandits. But I'll share some of these websites and I'll just go through a few of the things on there. So I do apologize if it's a bit long, but there's one thing I do request off anybody. Please comment about your experiences with mobile phone companies and just talk about it in the comments, because driving that up in the public eye will keep this going up in YouTube, etc., where Orange do not like to see this sort of stuff. So please feel free to tell me about your experience and how you're dealing with it. Thanks for watching. Now, the reason I'm putting this blog post on there is, although this one's fairly old, there's a lot of other issues with other people, and nothing's changed with Orange whatsoever. They're exactly the same. You've got people here that are being fined for their, basically, Orange has not done what they were supposed to, and then billed them for it. This one here, this is somebody was with Vodafone. They had an Orange sales rep walk into their office and basically promised them they would get a refund for the transaction penalty from Vodafone to Orange. They never paid it. Even with contacting Orange directly, with all the emails and everything from their sales rep, they were completely blanked. And basically, that's what they're saying here. I would just like to warn anyone living in Spain to be careful with Orange Mobile and never close any kind of contract with their sales reps or sales guys of any mobile phone company. They even lie to you in order to get that phone deal closed. I agree. And even when they don't close it, if you've signed something, they'll use it against you. Now, as we head down, there is all sorts of problems people have had. This one here, they were told they would get this set up. This is 2012. 1 cent billing for calling the UK, to then find out it was 1 cent plus 25 cents connection charge, then 2 cents per minute on the online billing. So obviously that 1 cent's a little bit more than they said, a lot more. And then there's the problems they had with trying to connect and the amount they got billed for that. This another one, internet and landline faulty for 4 months, no service. Same thing, they bill you, they don't, they promise you the earth, deliver nothing. This one here, mobile phone lines, similar problem. Orange with three reps. This one they had, as well as that was the mobile phones. That was the landline. The mobile phones, they also had a problem because his daughter tried to ask them about going on a lower tariff, and they automatically renewed a contract. And one of the things he did do is actually stress the fact that she had no authorization to do a new contract, but they blanked it and billed them for it. Worst experience, 45 years in business, can't get hold of them. As you go, communication, non-client orientated. And some of these are concerning. I do recommend having a read through these if you're serious about going with Orange or even with the other phone providers, because you'll find around the internet the same issues. But you'll find pretty much everybody on here is, they'll say Orange Spain is the worst. Online deal, ADSL router, landline, and two mobile SIMs. That's the same setup I had. We got the router, but no SIMs. When we phoned, they denied all knowledge of the SIM order, even though our bill showed ADSL plus two SIMs. So we redid the information. They promised to send the two SIMs again. Of course, no SIMs turned up. And again, they denied all knowledge of the SIM order. Plus, they were now charging the full price of €50 for ADSL plus two SIMs. We tried 5 times, each session less than 2-3 hours. Yada, yada, yada. Same problem. The people were friendly, but had no idea what the problem is, how to fix it, or what they could fix. We pleaded, we shared, we threatened, cancel, but not work. No one had a clue what went wrong. More than one Orange phone rep said this is a common problem. They sympathized, but couldn't help. That is standard. Bloody useless. I became a customer of Orange, internet, mobile, landline. Hello, another one. Suffering a lot after that. They changed my plan from Kangura 35 to Kangura Ahora without my permission. Moreover, they have been charging me more than double of what I should pay under this plan. They have been charging me 2-3 times each month with different amounts. Under the plan, one they're supposed to pay €42 a month if no extra calls are made. However, I've been paying more than €80 a month, for which they do not have any explanation. I have tried solving the problem several times. When I go to the stores, they give the customer care number. When I call them, they simply say they don't know why there are 2 or 3 bills and why the amounts are so much. Now I want to quit Orange, shift to Vodafone, but they don't have any clear information about the cancellation charges. I don't know how much money they will deduct from my bank for the cancellation. This is annoying. I have the same issue. There you go. I have also had problems with my other friends, have the same complaints. I've been with Orange customer for years, even since they phoned me at home and convinced me to change my provider over the phone right then and there. When I came to sell the property and tried to cancel the line 3 months in advance, I was unsuccessful and utterly infuriated in how difficult it is to cancel something that took 15 minutes to do. I cancelled the debits after I sold the property, and even after Orange still taking my money, I actually closed the account only to receive a final demand, a small amount, so I decided to pay it as life is too short, and when contacting the actual department, was greeted with rudeness and abuse, and they even tried to take my money from my credit card twice, even though I had insisted that while I was on the phone to them, I had received an automated message saying that they had taken the money. Realizing that I had paid, the second woman just put the phone down on me. An absolute disgrace. I would never use Orange in my lifetime. Orange is a law to themselves. So I'm not going to go through it, but you can see Orange is the worst telephone company ever. They're the worst I've dealt with. Now, I've dealt with telecommunication companies in the Philippines, and although they have bad service, they do not steal your money. These guys steal your money. They literally do. They're not only providing services they don't have, like trying to connect the internet they don't have access to, but then they fraudulently try to sell you services. And as you see there, some people have even been billed for services they ain't got, but they still want the money anyway. They go, oh, we don't know. They're idiots. Well, see, are they idiots? Because they're fraudulent and making a lot of money off the back of people that actually just want a good service? Or are we the idiots for signing up, or the fact that we don't know enough about them before we sign up? This is why this video is here. So that, I mean, if you sign up with them after seeing this video and these bits and pieces, then if you do get problems, it's your own fault. But I, for myself, I'm going to keep reinforcing this because they're a really bad company. Although some of these emails are very old, they're 2011, the company hasn't changed. It's exactly the same. They're still avoiding dealing with customers. There's 2015. What happens is there is no upper tier beyond the call center. There is nobody going to help you. The call center doesn't send anything anywhere. All you get is demands. You must pay this. You must do that. At the same time, it doesn't matter if their service is too bad or whatever. They don't care. They're threatened to give you a bad credit rating, even though it's not your fault. But what can you do to them? Very, very little. Thanks for watching.